What is up, everybody? Jason here. It is that time of year again where I get to launch sugar at the people that come to our door. And for Halloween this year, I decided to launch these creamy caramel candies. Not only are these delicious, they actually make great ammunition for a launching machine as they are pretty small and light. And they have this nice rectangular prism shape, which means they stack very easily. Conceptually, this year's launcher is quite simple. We have this gravity-fed magazine at the top, which holds the caramels, and we can just drop them in from the top. Currently it holds 9 caramels, but it can actually be pretty easily extended to hold more. At the bottom of the feed system, we have this slider, which just loosely rests within the frame, and it is pulled forward by these 2 rubber bands on either side. So as we push the slider back, it loads energy into those rubber bands. And once it clears the stack of caramels in the feed, they will drop. When the slider is released, the rubber bands will pull it forward and it will push the bottom caramel out the front. And if we release it quickly, it will launch the caramel. Of course, I don't want to manually control this launcher, so there are 2 motors in the back which control the launch sequence. And the reason I'm using 2 motors is it actually requires quite a bit of energy to load up these rubber bands. And having 2 motors just gives us a lot more torque to do that. They are also geared down quite a bit. If we take a look at the inside, and we can see that both motors drive the same drive axle, which transfers power through these gears to the launch arms. And there are 2 3-to-1 gear reductions in this gear train. And of course, 3 times 3 is 9, which means for every 9 rotations of the motor, there will be 1 rotation of the launch arms, which again, just gives us a lot more torque to load energy into those rubber bands. As the launch arms rotate, they will push back on these pins on either side of the slider, which will load energy into the rubber bands. Eventually, a stack of caramels will drop. And as the launch arms continue to rotate, they will eventually pass underneath these pins, which will cause the slider to be released and the caramel to be launched. And we can see that again. I also added a scissor mechanism at the front so I can adjust the launch angle. And I also added the proximity sensor in the front of the model so the kids can either put their hand in front of it or hold their bucket in front of it to trigger the launch sequence. I currently have the program configured to rotate the launch arms 1 full rotation, which will actually launch 2 caramels. And if we adjust the launch angle to its maximum, it should launch the caramels to just in front of the proximity sensor. I have created building instructions for this model if you would like to build it yourself. It is an alternate build of the Mindstorms Robot Inventor Kit, so if you have that set, you already have all the pieces you need to build it. The instructions and the program are freely available at jkbrickworks.com. I'll add a link in the description. Of course, if you do build it, you don't have to use these creamy caramel candies as ammunition. Pretty much anything that fits in the feed system will work. In fact, 2 stacked 2x2 bricks actually works quite well. I've even had some success launching these tiny little space babies, though they do not stack very well, so it's best to separate them with some 2x2 bricks. And that's about it for this one. I'm really excited to use this on Halloween night. It's always fun to launch sugar at kids. As always, thanks for watching. Keep on building, and we'll see you in the next one.